Okay, you got GIMP, you got two pictures, you want the two pictures to become one picture. Maybe you have to pay for each picture you have to upload to a site or something. So instead of paying for two pictures, you merge them so you have one picture containing both pictures. And that is what I'm about to show here. This is the beginning picture and this is the end picture. So I just made a big melon here because it was sort of fun. You can have different pictures there, of course, but I have the same pictures, you can say, but twice. You get it. So I will quit this. I will. You will open up a picture, and in the this program where you can preview pictures, I make a selection of part of the picture. I go into the preview program and the file menu, the edit menu, and choose copy. And now I can go to GIMP. I can choose create from clipboard. And it will select the sort of screenshot I took and put that part into the GIMP program. Ah, very good. We have one picture, but we want to have two pictures in our final picture. So this is just the beginning, as you can understand. So let's mark another part of this picture just for fun. It could be another completely other picture. You can have two cats or two dogs or whatever you want to merge here. But I make just another picture of this. So I go up to edit and make copy. And now I have it in my copy part. So what I'm going to do now is another layer, and this is where the complicated stuff probably starts for you. So Windows, Dockable Dialogues, and Layer. So then you get a layer menu, and in the layer menu you have this image you already have, but you need another layer to put another screenshot in. So create a new layer down here, and you can leave the presets as they are. Transparency important here. Click OK. Now you have a new layer that is transparent over the previous picture. You will not see any difference at all there. So what we do now, we do edit, and we can paste the new picture selection into GIMP, and it will not change at all. Same picture, because it takes the new part and it cuts it in here into the new picture. Maybe here it got a little bit twisted. But anyway, now we have two image layers, you think, but you got the third, and this is probably the hard stuff, I think. Floating selection. You want a floating selection to merge with a new layer. So you anchor that down on the layer, an anchor layer. Then the floating layer will be anchored to the new layer, and you have two layers as you intended. Okay, now we have a not a big canvas here. I can use the minus sign, then I zoom out, and we see that the picture is not big actually. We cannot hold two pictures here easily. But then we have to shrink the pictures and stuff like that. So what we want to do is increase the size of the canvas, and that you do under image and canvas size. Unmark the chain, it will make the increasing proportional, and I just want to increase the height here. So something like that. Resize. And you will have this checkerboard pattern. It will not be checkerboard pattern in the final image. It will be transparent actually. So not white, not black, not gray, just transparent. And now we have two pictures here, and I want to move one of the pictures down a bit. So let's mark the upper layer. Let's mark the lower layer. It actually depends here which layer is marked. That's the part, that's the layer you're going to move. And the lower layer, if I lower that picture, it will be more logical that the lower layer is the lower picture in the final picture. I think you get it. Here, move tool, double click on that, and click on the layer, and then you can use shift and arrow down. Then you do greater increments. So you can do this faster. if you don't have the shift pressed down, then it's like maybe pixel by pixel or something like that. So now we move that down. We have separated the layers from each other here, or the picture parts in the layers. So go to a new layer, the upper layer here, and I want to reverse that. So I go to the reverse tool, double click on that. I use horizontal, not vertical, not horizontal. And I click outside the picture, the layer actually. Something like that. Then it will flip this over vertically. We are getting there soon, having a whole melon. So what will I do now? Well, I will move up the low layer. So let's mark the low layer. Very important which layer is chosen here. Very, very important. When you have 23 layers, it's important that you actually have the right layer chosen that you want to do the manipulation with. So click here, move tool, click in the layer, and shift an up arrow here. And then you can do like fine tuning with like without shift here. But it's not that important. You're intelligent. You get the picture here. You have taken one. You're taking two pictures and made one picture of it, sort of. Now there is some part down here that is not actually being used. And let's remove that. And you can do that with the selection tool. So double click on that. You can be even outside a picture here if you like. But it's a bit I missed there. So maybe something like this. Do it. I mark here. I select this part. And down here. And then I go to image and fit canvas to selection. And the canvas will be shrunked. Now there are some layers here that are actually smaller than the picture. It doesn't really matter for the final result, but you can go to layers and you can go to layer to image size. So it will be better. Oh, something like that. Now you have two layers. Maybe you want to merge them down, but it's actually not really necessary. But merge the upper layer down, mark the upper layer, do merge down. You will have like one image, the combination of these. And now you can go to file and save a copy. And let's call this bigger melon. And you have to have a file extension, GPG. J. Well, whatever, my English is so bad. I'm so happy my girlfriend is not at home. She's attending a women's dinner party. Why don't you do the tutorials in Swedish, Michael? She says, well, I will not reach any audience at all. So save. And export is probably a question you're gonna get. And you can increase the quality if you want to. And save. And now you will have an image looking like this one in the documents file here, or documents catalog. Well, thank you for listening. Bye.